most ladies be like, I want a good fearing man and the man who will tolerate my actions. My friend, let me tell you now. Who told you that there is any man who don't fear God? Every man is godly, and from the fact is, a man was created direct by God and was the first one to be created by God. So don't blame that. Okay, let us go ahead. From that perception, I can tell you, every man is a God-fearing man. It is you to take that man and say, now together we can do this and this, A, B, C, D. Also, they say that I want a man who will tolerate my actions. Now that is where the tough comes from. Who told you that there is a man who will entertain your ambiguity, your abnormality? Oh my God, my ladies, let me tell you this now. Take this to your accounting books. There is no man who will take up your ambiguity. It is you to go up with that man, to change and suit in the feet of that man. Okay, it doesn't mean that a man should not change to fit in the suit of a lady. You have to change each other. That's what the Bible says. A man will leave his parents. Woman leave his parents. They come together to make one thing. Meaning, you might take it for granted that way as it is, but it means you have to change to fit into marriage as a man changes to fit into marriage. Though I met other people told me that they could have just been genuine to say that a woman will leave his bed at home to go to the man's place for a bed. Okay, it might be, I don't know. But what I will really tell you that you have to change, stop your ambiguity, stop your immorality, change to suit into marriage. You are to become parent. Okay. Now, when we go to the point is that that man seducing you now is the man God has sent you, is the man whose rib that made you, the man that God took the rib from to create you. You might not know. Okay, there's a saying that human beings are unsatisfactory. Yes, true, they are unsatisfactory. That's why you will see a lady dumping a gold going to pick out stones. This doesn't mean that a man also doesn't do that. Men also are similar. Human beings are unsatisfied. But despite so, we have to be in a manner that we show the satisfactory mood. Okay, God created you a lady from a rich man, and that man seducing you. Let's conclude that is the man whose rib God made you from. So don't go astray to that. That I don't want it because he doesn't mind. Okay, God created you to make a change in people's life. You are capable to take him and change him from the situation he is to the situation you want him to be. Actually, this is true. God created you and gave you the nobility to make a change in somebody's life. Ask yourself, which person have you ever made a change? Now let me tell you, you are seeing this guy is a drunkard, is not capable of doing anything. But let me tell you, that's the man God have sent you to make a change from. And the moment you make a change from him, to make him to be a valuable person that you want, that is how God wants you to do. When you say that you can't go to that person, actually you are evading the God's plan. And remember, God will make you back there. Don't forget the story of Jonah in the Bible, who was escaping from going to preach the word of God where God has sent him. What did he do? He packed his thing to enter the boat. He slept. Oh, okay, that is what happened. And he found he was thrown into the sea. Whale took him, swallowed him. He lived in the stomach of the whale for a while. He was just brought back by the whale to the place where God sent him. Don't take that for granted. Actually, you are the Jonah that God is looking for. You are the Jonah who I have to treat there. Even if you evade, you will come back there. Idea, I mean this. You damn this guy that because he is this way. There's another one waiting for you next door. The same character. The best thing is to change where you are, to make a change where you are, not to change the place, but to change that person to fit what you want. We are going ahead well. Okay, this is what I mean. Change that drunkard man to church man. Okay, that's what God have given you an ability to do. And that's why I found yourself there, not just for granted, but by God's plan. Change him from single to husband. And actually, when you change him from single to husband, automatically you'll change him from his name to a daddy. And you are not the exception. You'll be changed from the single to mother, then mother to mom. That is what God have made you to do. Never miss that. Okay, I mean this. Let him be called a husband to somebody. Let him be called person who have changed and be the dream of other people. Through you, you can. And you, man, I'm not accepting you, my friend. Change that lady from who she is. They call him that she, most people say that she may not get married. Surprise them, marry her the way she is. Change him from a girl to a wife, from her name to a mother. That is what God have given you an ability to do. Okay. It may be wise or not wise. You may take it for granted, but that is what God has sent me to tell you. If you change someone, accept to be changed, to change too. If you make a change in somebody's life, accept to be changed too. And this one we can start from here. Change yourself. If you be flexible to be changed, then it means you can change yourself. This is the world God created us, not to criticize and be selective. God created you not to criticize others, not to be selective, but to take that person others are criticizing and make him the person people will admire and be an example of. And that is how God wants. You might say, oh, I go to church, I do this, no, I want a church man. No, you go to church, yes. So you go to church, so what? You want a church guy? So you go to church, so what? You want a church lady? No. If you go, let us take the story of Jesus. When he was interacting with wicked mother, the well, people say that why Jesus is holy interacting with that man. He said, I didn't come for the righteous, but I came for the wicked. This means he came for the wicked to change them to be righteous. If you are already righteous, why do you want to take righteous? Take that person that people think that he is a wicked and change him or her to the righteous. God created you to change the world to the righteous way, not to be righteous to righteous, but righteous to wicked. Then change that wicked to righteous. That's where God chose you to change. Okay, I finished to say this. You are a queen and you are a king. Okay, let me clarify then. You are a queen, he is a king. You men, you are a king, he is a queen. And that comes in only if you come together and create that kingdom. That kingdom is godly kingdom. That kingdom is the kingdom that will be perceived in a positive way to people, will be example to other people, will be the icon that he was drunkard and he was changed to a church person and he is making a good husband. It is you who have made it. Even if they don't recognize you, God will recognize you. Okay, I finish by saying this. Kindly, this is a Pluto African TV encouragement. This is episode 1. Don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe to Pluto Africa TV channel. There's more episodes coming. Don't forget to click that bell that will come after subscription. That bell will give you and will mean you'll be getting every notification that I upload and will be the first person to listen to this encouragement. I'm yours, honestly, Dr. Pluto.